Hey guys, my name is Jayesh Pawar. In today's session, we are going to learn how to solve 1D beam element subjected to bending load. Now let's go to the HyperWorks. This is your UI, user interface. Then in user profile, just select OptiStruct. We are going to use OptiStruct as a solver. Click OK. We are going to follow the same procedure as before. The first thing is to create a material. So click on the material icon, give a name as steel, give any random color as you want, and then the type as isotropic and the card image as mat 1. As you know that mat 1 is used to create a property, material properties. So click on create and edit, and then you have to activate E, mu and rho. Once you do that, just click on return and then again click on return. So the next thing is to create a cross section. Go on 1D and select hyper beam. Make sure you are in standard section and select thin wall box. Click on create. Once you do that, another page will be opened and give a dimensions to it. A, B and T, as you know that A is 50 mm, B is also 50, and the thickness is 5 mm. To fit the screen, you can just press F from your keyboard or you can go from here, the fit to screen option, and then exit the file. Okay, your cross section has been created, so click on return. Now the next thing is to create a property. So click on the property icon and give a name as 1D beam, give any random color as you want, and the type as 1D, card image as P-beam, material, the thing which we have created right now, and the cross section also, box section. Click on create and edit. Now I would like to say here that in this format we have to give a coordinates. As you know, if we are going to give a bending load, there will be no stresses on the center line, and the top face is going to be in the tensile and the bottom face is going to be in the compression. So in this format, C1 and C2 will be the coordinates of C point, means the top side. D1 and D2 will be the coordinates of right hand side. E1 and E2 will be the coordinates for downward side, and F1 and F2 will be for left hand side. And to activate that C1, C2, D1, D2, E1, E2, F1, F2, we need to go over here. Continuation line L, line 2. Once you do that, we can activate C1, C2, D1, D2, E1, E2 and F1, F2. These are the coordinates at which we are going to find out the deformation and stresses. Our cross section is aligned at the center. So from the center, C1 and C2 will be 25, 0. So C1 will be 25 and C2 will be 0. D1 will be 0, 25. So D1 is 0 and D2 is 25. E1 will be -25 and E2 will be 0. E1 will be -25, E2 will be 0. And F1 will be 0 and F2 will be -25. So F1 is 0, F2 will be -25. So just click on return. Click on return. Now you have also specified at the point at which you are going to calculate the stresses. Now we have to create a component. So to create a component, just click on component icon and give a name, 1D beam. 1D beam. Give any random color. And make sure you are in no card image, and select a property which we have created, PB. As you can see, the property has been displayed over here. Just click on create and return. Now we are going to create a component. As you can see, the length of a component is 1000 mm. So just go on the geometry and nodes page. First node we are going to create at x0, y0, z0. Click on create. And the second node which we are going to create at x1000, y0, z0. Click on create. A node has been created. If you want to see the nodes, just press F. That will fit your geometry to the screen. Or you can directly do from here, fit to screen option, and click on return. Once you are done with it, we are going to create a beam element. So go on the 1D page, click on bar, select a property as 1D beam and element type as C beam. For orientation, we have to select a plane which is normal to our axis. So there are two planes which are normal to our axis, to Y axis and Z axis. So just click on Y axis, or you can click on Z axis as you wish, because our cross section is symmetric. So just click on two nodes and go return. Once you do that, your C beam has been created. You can see our beam over here. Yeah, this is how it looks. Yeah, now the next step is to create a loads. So click on load, create a load as SPC, which is single point constraint. We are going to fix one side. So click on create and return. Go on the analysis page, click on constraint. Select a node at which you want to give a constraint. I am going to select this node and make sure that all the degrees of freedom have been picked, which means there is no rotary motion or not a translation motion, and click on create. You can see the fix has been created. Return. Again, go on node collector, click on force, create a force and give a color. Click on create. Click on return. Go on analysis. Click on force. We can directly set from orientation XY plane. Go on analysis. Click on force. The magnitude is in lakh. And now we have to orient it to Y direction. Click on Y axis and in negative Y. So click on create. Oh, sorry, I forgot to select node. Just select a node and click on create. Okay, now you can see the force has been created. Click on return. Now the last step remaining is load step. So click on load step. Make sure SPC and load has been ticked. In SPC, we have to select SPC, which is fixed, and in load we have to select force which we have applied. Click on create and return. Once you do that, the last step remains is to save a file. So I'm just going to save a file. File, save as. It works. Lecture 2. I'm just going to name a file as problem 2. Click on save and then go in OptiStruct and run the file by using OptiStruct option. So the result has been created. Click on result. Okay, now we are going to orient it at XY plane. So we have selected XY plane. Go in the contour. Just click on deformation, click on apply. You can see the deformation over here. Select result type as stresses. In stresses, now I will show you. We know that we have selected C, B, E, F, the points at which we have selected this C, D, E, and F. And now we are going to see the stresses at generated at E point. So just drop down over here and SAC, click a value, select as simple, click apply. You can see the stresses generated over here. We are not getting negative sign, which is it is a tensile stress. Now we are going to see at point D point we should have getting a zero stresses. Click on here. As you can see, when I click on apply, we are getting zero stress. Now click on E point, we should get compressive stress, means a negative value. As you can see, we are getting a negative value, which means it is a compressive stress. And F point, again we should get a no stress, zero value. So click, let's see. Okay, we have got a zero value. This is how we solve a beam problem which is subjected to bending load. Thank you.